All right, welcome back to another video. As you can see, I am back on my Blackdawn OS. I wanted to share some of the updates and things I've added to my configuration and how I have them implemented. I am back on my NixOS. I was on Arch for a little while just because I have been using Niri, which I still am on Niri, as you can see here. I'm on Niri Wayland up there. I figured out how to get a lot of my issues figured out on my NixOS build. One being a huge one was I have 3 monitors, and whenever I go to play a full screen game, it would not capture the actual mouse into the full screen game. And if I would move my mouse, so if I'm aiming at something and I want to, you know, do a quick turn, my mouse would actually leave the monitor and go to the monitor that's to my right. And then obviously that's not good for like a first person shooter, and it would mess me up. So their fix, Niri themselves do have on their wiki page that you're supposed to use GameScope for games, but sometimes GameScope, it just works weird sometimes. And I couldn't really get GameScope working very well on my NixOS build. So that's why I was on Arch for a little while, because I was able to get GameScope and performance working on there. So I ended up creating my own script where I'll actually put space between my monitors, so that way the monitors are no longer touching. That way my mouse cannot move. As you can see right now, my mouse is leaving the monitor on the right-hand side here. But if I turn on the script, which normally there'd be a notification, I have my notifications turned off up here, but as you can see, it says gaming mode turned on, so that notification did pop up. So now I actually can't leave my monitor. It's getting stuck right here at the end, and I can't leave on this side either. So that way I can actually game, but I can still get to my other monitors because I have a keybind for, you know, just going to next monitor. So now I'm on my right monitor, back to this one, and then onto the left monitor. So I can still get to every monitor very easily, but now my mouse is confined to the monitor, not the game. I had trouble getting it to do the game, so I went a step above the hierarchy and went to the monitor itself, and it's been working great. So that's my fix for the gaming side of things. I created a script for it, added it to my configuration. If I go under modules, home, and then scripts, I have the Niri gaming mode. It has the state of the monitor for off and on. It sets the positioning of the monitors differently. So it puts it back to the normal default standing with the normal mode. Then it sets them far apart using the Niri message output option for each monitor. And then I can just run it with my key binding, which I added into my config here under the host itself and keybind. So now I have this script for Control Shift G. If I want to get to the screen, I can just do it again. As you can see here, I got another notification saying gaming mode off. Now I can move freely between all the screens. So that's my fix for that. It seems to be working pretty well. It's not ideal, but it does work where I can still run my games natively the way I want to run them without having to use GameScope, but still have full flexibility to keep my mouse confined to the monitor itself. Another fix, this is just Niri in general, not just NixOS. If you are using the Zed editor, you may find out that when you launch it on Niri, it's not interactive. You cannot do anything. But I found that if you resize it or move it from one monitor to another, it gains that interaction back. So what I end up doing is creating another script called Zed Fix. And this one is to basically just move the column width on 1% and then move it back 1%. So it just resizes itself really quick. It's really not that noticeable. So if I actually close that out and reopen it, you can kind of see it go in and out really quickly, but overall it just opens and I can use it as is. And then I can resize it to whatever the size that I want to have the window on. That's the other fix that I did add in here. And I was able to add all of the different shells as well. If I go into my variable.nix, I have the DMS shell, which is the one I have installed right now, as you can see. And then I have Noctalia shell as well. And then I have your standard waybar. The way I switch between these is just from this variable here. So if I put Noctalia in here and then do a rebuild on my system, then it'll actually be on Noctalia. I do have to switch out of the session and then log back in for the bar to launch correctly, or I can do a pkill DMS and then, you know, launch the Noctilia one manually. If I just want to stay in my session, I'd have to log out. But one of the people in my Discord actually made a really cool cell switcher option, which I'm going to be implementing it into my system as well. Leno. So basically, if you see here, he created a option that opens a Rofi, and then you can select whatever shell you want to have. And I'm actually switched it. And this is also, as you can see on NixOS, he's actually using my locked on OS as well, but this one's on Hyperland, so I'm probably going to fork it and create one for Niri as well to work with it. And so I might add this into my system so that you switch between each shell, you know, quickly and easily without having to, you know, do anything extra. So I thought that was a really cool way of that, so you don't have to do the whole rebuild and switch. I definitely will be trying to configure something like that into my system. That's also a new thing I added. With that being said, with all of these options for keybinds, I did add it so there is the keybinds are conditional based on which bar is selected. If Noctilia is selected, the launcher is going to launch the Noctilia launcher. Since I have DMS selected, it's going to launch the DMS one. And if I have Waybar selected, I'm going to do the Rofi option there. That makes it easy. You don't have to either comment out or change your keybinds, especially if the bind is the same. I have mod space to open that, but it's going to be mod space for all three of them. I need to have it select which one I want from there. That's how I have that set up, which has been working out pretty well. And I did finally get Niri configured into the Nix language and everything. I did have to use Claude Code to help me with that because I was getting stuck left and right as far as actually trying to implement it and make it modular, you know, within my system and have everything be, you know, symlinked and sourced out correctly. That's where I was having a lot of issues. I was able to get that working and running, and it's been working really well. Also, I did add the web app install option here. So this one I actually just pretty much stole from the Amarchi web app creator, but just rewrote it. So basically I can do web app install, and then it says, you know, name the app that I want to do. So I actually do need to create a Google Meet web app. So I'm going to say meet, and then the URL is https://meet.google.com. Enter, and then you can select the icon and the dashboard icon option. And then I can just say Google Meet. And then there's the icon. We'll go ahead and copy that and then go back here and paste it. And so now if I do lon space and then type in Google Meet, there it is. You got Google Meet up and running. So it makes it pretty easy to do. And also you can remove them with web app. You can either just type in the name that you want, or if you do remove, it'll list them all and you can select the one you want and delete it. So pretty much the exact same way that Marchi had it installed. I really like the way that was, because the other ones like Cosmic One and the web app manager from Linux Mint, all of those, they're good. It is GUI and easy to use, but they still have their finicky issues. This is just really straightforward. It's really just creating the desktop file in the correct directory and then adding the app icon in the correct directory. Boom, it's just opening the app in a window with no borders or applying the correct window rules. So I did add that in there, which has been working well. And then I also did add the option to actually switch your window manager, which one you want to have active on your system. One of my Discord members, D-Dubs, had mentioned, like, what if they want both? I do need to make it so you can just have both enabled as well. But specifically, I made it so you can select which one you wanted to use in the actual install script. You guys can try the install script. I am still working out some bugs in the install script, but it does go through and actually ask you, like, which your host you want to be, and then information about your device as far as like what profile is going to do. It will pick it up automatically as far as your GPU, and if it's correct, you just select yes, and then it goes through. And then allow you to define what your username is. You can just use the predefined ones if you want to. If you are going to end up either forking it or creating your own repo with it, then I would suggest doing it. Then you do also have time and keyboard configuration and then the console. But then it gets into which window manager you want to use. You can pick Hyperland or Niri, and then that makes the flag which one you want it to be, as you can see here. But in doing so, it's only enabling one at a time and not both. I probably should add a third option for both to be enabled. That way, if you want to log out to SDDM and switch to whatever you want, you can. And then I have terminal choices, Kitty, Alacrity, and Ghosty for your default browser. You can choose between these options. I also have your shell option. The default is CSH, but I also added fish because I do like fish. I probably will switch my main one to fish initially, but I do have like bash in here too. I probably should add bash as a default option, but, and then you can also choose your bar and shell choice. So I have Noctilia, DMS, and Waybar. I do want to get the ported version of the Celestia one on here for Niri, so that way you can have that one as well. But I didn't want to add it since it's only available for Hyperland right now. I'm on the Niri one currently myself. So I probably will add that. And if you choose Waybar, you get to choose between the different Waybar configurations that I have in here, and then your animations, and that's it. I did update the install script for everything. Kind of figure out what you want for your configuration before you install it. And then it goes through and applies that and rebuilds and applies all the changes to your actual build. If the build passes, we'd be able to come into your VR.nix and change any of those sources if you want to. By default, it'll be whatever you selected in the actual install script. So yeah, I wanted to show some new things that I've added to my S with Niri now enabled and the different scripts for game mode, web apps, and the Zed fix. And then also that I probably will be adding in that option to be able to like hot swap between different bars within the configuration, which would be really nice. If you have been enjoying my content, please consider liking the video and subscribing for more. I will catch you guys in the next one. Peace.